Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss how to draw the projections of a given cone. Here the given question is, draw the projections of a cone of base diameter 40 mm and axis 60 mm resting on a point of the base circle on the ground with axis inclined at 30 degrees to the HP and first bit, 45 degrees to the VP and B bit, top view of the axis inclined at 45 degrees to the VP. Here we need to do the projections of a cone. Projections means front view and top view of the cone at the different positions. Okay, here cone means it is a solid, it has one base, it is circular shape. Okay, it is like circle, and then it has one point. This point is called apex. Okay, this circle and apex are joining with the generators. Generator means if you are seeing this side, this is one generator and this is another generator. Okay, infinite number of generators will be there on this inclined surface. Okay, so this point we are calling apex. Okay, and here roughly I did it the cone. Okay, this is the apex, this is the base circle, and here the line passing through center of this circle. Let us assume one center will be there for here, and this apex. Okay, I'm giving O here, center of the circle is O1. The line joining O to O1 is called axis. This is the imaginary line. Okay, this height O to O1 height we are calling small h, height of the cone, or axis also we can call. Okay, so here first write down the given data, after that we will see. Here base diameter is given 40 mm. Okay, so this diameter of the circle is 40 mm, and then they have given axis is 60 mm. Axis means just now I told it is the height of the cone. Okay, how much it is? 60 mm they have given, and again they have given some conditions. So instead of conditions I have written stage 1, stage 2, stage 3. So here I took the first condition. In stage 1 they have given this cone is resting on a point of the base circle on the ground. Okay, same thing I have written here. The next stage is axis is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. Same thing I took here. After that they have given two bits in the stage 3. First bit is axis is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Same thing I have written. And the second bit has given top view of the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. So top view of the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. So we are keeping all the solids according to our syllabus in the first quadrant. Okay, so this is the 3D form of first quadrant. This is the vertical plane and this is the horizontal plane, and the line joining both planes is XY line. In the first quadrant I am keeping the cone. As I shown, cone is, it has base, circular base, and one apex, it has some height. Okay, like that we are keeping the cone. Here we need to do the projections of it. Projections means front view of this cone, how the cone is looking in the front view. Shortcut form I am writing FV here. Okay, and we need to do the top view of this cone also. Both front view and top view is called projections. Okay, if you see from front, this cone is looking like triangle. Okay, so where we can see the triangle, we can see the triangle in the vertical plane. Okay, so here we can see, if you see this here front view, we can see it is looking like triangle. Okay, the triangle is coming above XY line. Okay, if you do the XY line, it is looking like this in the vertical plane. Okay, it is called front view. For getting top view, we have to see this cone from the top. We can see the triangle. We can see the circle. If you see from top, we can see the circle here. Okay, this circle we can see on the horizontal plane. Okay, and then here this gap has not given. We can take any gap from cone to the vertical plane. Okay, we can see the circle on the horizontal plane in the top view. Again, we have to tilt this horizontal plane in downward direction like this. Why we are tilting is, this is a 3D form. We have to get in 2D form. So this horizontal plane is coming below the vertical plane, below the XY line. This horizontal plane is coming below the XY line. Both planes will be coming like this after tilting. Okay, this is XY. This is the vertical plane. This is the horizontal plane. Correct? Front view is coming like triangle, just now I told. And top view, as I told, one circle we can see. The gap has not given from vertical plane. So this top view is looking like this. For getting at the same lines, we have to do the projector lines, light color. Okay. So this gap has not given. So same thing I did here. This is above XY line, it is a vertical plane. We can see the front view. Below XY line, it is the top view in the horizontal plane. Okay, these are the projections in 2D form. Okay, we need to do this projection for the first stage. For doing it, first we have to do the XY line of any length. So here I am doing XY line. Okay, this is x, this is y. Here I did the xy line. Here after some gap, do one circle. It is a top view. Diameter of the circle is 40 mm, 4 cm. Radius is 2 cm. Okay. Take 2 cm radius. Take any one of the point is center. Do circle. The center here. Center of the base is O1. Okay. After that, do the horizontal diameter. Take this is the reference. Do the horizontal diameter here. So at these points, do the projectile lines up to the xy. As we know, projectile lines are in light color. At the center also, do the axis line. Okay. So as we know, axis line is two big lines with a dot. Like this. Axis height above the xy is 6 centimeters. It is cone height. So from xy, take 6 centimeters and extend the axis line. So mark the end point. Now here join these points to this apex. Give the name for apex, O it is. Join O to these two points. So this, it is looking like triangle. Okay, like this. Here we can see this edge, we can see this edge. Like that, we have to do the inclined lines. This is the front view, this is the top view. First we did top view, after that for getting the front view we did the projector lines. Here let us assume number of generators are there. For getting the correct cone shape, we have to divide this circle into 12 divisions. Okay. So here at the center of the circle, angle is 360 degrees. Okay, we have to divide this 360 degrees into 12 divisions. Okay, we have to make this circle into 12 parts. This angle divided by 12. Okay, each angle is 30 degrees. Okay. Now mark 30 degrees here by using the protractor so that we can get number of generator. Here it is 0, again 30, 30 plus 30 means 60, 90 already we did here, and then 90 plus 30 means 120, 120 plus 30 means 150. Join all these points to the center and extend the line. Q, small letters A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L. Okay, after that, draw the projector lines at all the points. Take this is the reference. Here mark the intersection points. Small a in the top view we are giving, in the front view a dash. Here b dash, l dash. Here c dash, k dash. Here d dash, j dash. Both points are coming here in the top view at the same point. Here e dash, I dash. Here f dash, h dash. Here g dash. Take this point and join to the apex. Okay, this is the front view, this is the top view, and these are the generators we have created by dividing this circle. Stage 1, take the next stage, that axis is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. Okay, this is the axis, it is inclined at 30 degrees to the horizontal plane like this. Okay, if you are taking the cone, okay, initially it is like this triangle, this entire triangle is tilting like this, so that this axis means imaginary line, this imaginary line is tilting 30 degrees to the horizontal plane. Whatever front view is here, it is tilting like this. Okay, so take this point is on the HP only, so that in the first stage they have given one of the point is resting on the ground. Let us take this point is G dash we are marking, and after some gap here on the XY, take G dash here. Okay, now entire triangle is tilting like this, roughly I am doing here. Now here axis is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. Axis means, as we know, it is passing through center. Okay, two big lines with a dot like this. Let us assume roughly here, this is the axis line. It is tilting 30 degrees. Okay, with the horizontal plane like this. Now, how much this angle? As we know, axis is perpendicular to the base. Okay, 90 degrees to the base. Here also axis is perpendicular to base. Okay, how much this angle? This is also 90. Okay, here this side 90 means this side also 90. And what about this angle? If you are taking, this is a bigger part, roughly I am doing here. This angle is 30 and this angle is 90. Okay, how much this angle? In the triangle, as we know, sum of all three angles, that is 30 degrees plus 90 degrees. Let us take, this is theta. Theta is equal to, sum is 180. Okay, find out this value, theta value. Theta is equal to 180 minus 90 minus 30. So how much it is? These two means 120, it is 60 degrees. Okay, so this angle is 60 degrees. Okay, here if you are doing this diagram again, here this base is making how much angle? We got 60 degrees. Okay, at that time axis is making 30 degrees here. So we got this point, that's why I am taking this angle. Okay, G dash point. At G dash, do the 60 degrees line here. And on it, mark whatever base is there, base length, mark that length. Okay, how much base length? It is the diameter of this circle. That is 4 cm. Already I have marked G dash here. Here, do the 60 degrees line. 60 degrees. So, in this direction, do this 4 cm. 4 cm means from 6 to 2. It is 4 cm. Okay, this length I have marked on the 60 degrees line. And this end point is A dash. Okay, mark this apex also. As we know, this is a triangle. Take this length and this length. Take the intersection point is apex by using compass. Take this length. Just do an arc here. Similarly, take this length. It is also same. Okay. Cut this arc. This intersection point is apex O. Join these two points to apex. Now after getting it, do all the points on the base by using compass. Mark this point. This point is F dash, H dash. Next point, E dash, I dash. And middle point. D dash, J dash. A dash. Here C dash. Next B dash, L dash. Here B dash, L dash. Okay. Now join all these points to the apex. Just for marking the angle, axis is tilting. How much angle with HP? 30 degrees angle. It has given in this condition. Axis is inclined at 30 degrees to HP. Just extend the axis and mark the 30 degrees. After getting the axis, here DJ marked at the same point, and this center is also coming at this point. This is O1. Okay, O1 dash on the base. Okay, so mark the same point here also, O1 dash. Okay, after getting all these points, do the projector lines. Take any one of the line is the reference line. From these points also do the projector lines. Take this is the reference. Mark the intersection points. Okay. A horizontal line, A vertical line. This is A point. B horizontal line, B vertical line. Mark this is B. And similarly C vertical line. And C horizontal, mark C point here. and then next D point, D horizontal and then D vertical, mark D here, and E horizontal, E vertical, mark E point, F horizontal, F vertical, mark F here, G horizontal, G vertical, mark G, H horizontal, H vertical, H, I horizontal, I vertical, mark I, J horizontal, J vertical, mark J, K vertical, K horizontal, mark K, L horizontal, L vertical, mark L. So like that we got from A to L all the points. Mark the apex also, mark the center also, O1 dash vertical line, O1 horizontal line, mark this is center O1 for apex, this is O and it is meeting at the center, this is O, here O dash, okay, for the front views we are giving dash, okay. Now here join all outer points with continuous, okay. Now here if you see from top, we can see only half of the cone. Let us take here, if you see the cone like this, okay, we can see only this part, we can't see the remaining half, okay. So whatever outer points we can see that part, the inner points we have to take the dotted line, so invisible part should be in dotted, okay. Now here when it is tilting we can see these generators also, end generators, those are also the visible lines, okay. Now join this O to J and O to D with continuous, and this part should be in the circular form and this part should be with dotted, which is outer point here J, J and O join with continuous line. And then O to D, like this, okay. I'll join this part with freehand curve. This is a stage 2 diagram. In the stage 2, this axis is tilting 30 degrees to HV. And according to the stage 1, one of the point is on the HV only. So G point is on the horizontal plane. Okay, take the third stage. In the third stage, first bit, axis is making 45 degrees to the VP. Okay, so line is making angle with VP means it is coming below XY. Took this center here at some gap after this diagram. Okay, so here I will take 45 degrees line. For taking 45, just do one small horizontal line at O1. Just do like this. And at O1, take 45 degrees line. And take 45 here, okay. So join in this direction, do one line here, 45 degrees line, this line is tilting 45 degrees. Now this is we are considering axis, how much length of the axis, it is 6 centimeters given in the question, just mark 6 centimeters on that line by using this as center, mark on this line, okay. Now here we are getting the arc, okay, just extend this line for getting the intersection point up to this, okay. Take this intersection point is some O2. After getting O2, just do one horizontal line, it is locus of O2, okay. Take this is the reference line, at O2 do the horizontal line. Here I took the 6 centimeters axis length, but here in the top view, this length is less than 6 centimeters. If you measure here, it is coming 5 cm only, okay. Why it is reduced means here we are tilting the entire cone, okay. In the tilting means it is looking like inclined axis, inclined axis length is here we are seeing it is less than 6 cm. So mark this 6 cm in this gap, okay, on the locus of this apex, okay. Take this length, whatever length is here, take this length, O1 as center, do an arc here, okay. Here we are getting the intersection point, so this is I am taking O. Okay, now our axis is O1 to O, okay, because it is reduced one, we are taking this is our axis. Do the axis line with two big lines with a dot. Okay, and now we got O1 point, O point here. Now build this entire diagram here, okay. O1, O line, A and G are also coming on the same line. So extend this line here. So I have extended this line here. Now mark A point from O1 to A. And similarly O1 to G also same length. So here I did one arc. And here also I did one arc on the same line. Okay. So this point is A point. Intersection point. This point is G point. So after marking A and G, mark remaining points also. I will take A as center. L as AL as radius, and similarly AB is also same distance. I will do two arcs at both sides of A. Here one arc, here this side one arc. Okay, so from A to these two arcs at it. Similarly, we know G point also. From G point take BG length. This length and this length are same. Okay, BL length. So take this length, GB length and GL length same. So G as center, cut this arc, cut this arc. You will get A point here. So this side B point, intersection point, this side L point. After marking B and L here, mark C and K also. This is K point. Okay, this distance, C and K distance here. So from A, take this distance, CA. CA distance and AK distance same. Okay, so A as center, do one arc this side and do another arc this side. Okay, similarly from G also take those distances, CG distance and KG distance. Cut this arc and cut this arc, and here extend this arc. Okay. Now take the intersection point. After B it is C, so after L it is K. This point is K. After C and K, mark this distance D and J. Okay. Take from distance A, both are same here. From A take those arcs here, this arc and this arc. Similarly from G also take those distance, those are same. Okay, from G cut these arcs. Now give the intersection names. For this point it is D, here after K it is J. Mark these remaining points also on it. Now after J and D take I, AI distance, and then EI distance, AE distance same. Mark arc here, this side and this side. Similarly from G take, similarly I and E from G, GA distance and GE distance same. From G cut these arcs. Give the intersection points. So E and I, this is E, this is I. So after E I, mark this distance F and H. Okay, AF distance by using compass, and then same AH distance. Similarly A as center, do an arc this side and this side, and then similarly take from G as center, GH distance and GF distance same. G as center, cut these arcs, here extend this arc, AH distance here. Okay, so mark the points H and F. Here this side is after E, after E this is F and this is H. Okay, after getting all the points, whatever continuous curves are there, do continuous here, and whatever continuous lines are there, here also do the continuous line with this apex, not with this apex. Okay, so O and J join the continuous line. So this is the J point and this is the D point. Join these two with continuous. After that, do this or continuous curve. Now at these points, do the projectile lines, vertical projectile lines. Take this is the reference line. From these points also do the projectile lines. Take this is the reference. Now take the intersection points, A horizontal line and A vertical line. Take this is C dash. Similarly B horizontal line, B vertical line. Take this is B dash. Similarly C vertical line, C horizontal line. Take this is C dash. D horizontal line, take this is D dash. E horizontal line, E vertical line, take this is E dash. f horizontal line, f vertical line, take this is f dash, g horizontal line, g vertical line, take this is g dash, h vertical line, h horizontal line, take this is h dash, I horizontal line, I vertical line, okay, take this is I dash, take this is I dash, and j vertical line, j horizontal line, take this is j dash, k horizontal line, k vertical line, take this is k dash, l vertical line, l horizontal line, take this is l dash. Okay, we got all the alphabets from A to L. Now mark the center also. So at the center also do the line. Okay, center vertical line, center horizontal line, take this is O1. Similarly, apex vertical line, apex horizontal line, this is O1 dash. We need mark all outer points with continuous lines. A dash, B dash, C dash, this part should be continuous curve. Okay, do with freehand curve. These are the inner points, do with dotted. So this is also dotted, J is also inner point. L, K, J, K, L are the inner points. So this portion should be dotted. Join outer points with the apex, with continuous lines. Now here I to O1, it is a continuous. Now this is a front view in the stage 3 first bit. Okay, here we will write stage 3, which bit it is A bit. Now take the next bit. The top view of the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to VB. Here which is the top view, this is the top view. Okay, so top view axis is less length. This length is tilting 45 degrees with VP. Always remember, line is making angle with VP means we are getting the line below XY. Here in this case, the axis is tilting 45, original axis. Okay, that is axis length 6 cm is tilting 45. Now he has given in B bit, top view axis is tilting. Whatever axis length is here, the same length is tilting 45 degrees here. We have to construct the same diagram here also on the 45 degrees line. Okay, just mark the center. Take this point is O1. Okay, and mark 45 degrees line on it, mark this length. So for marking angle, take this is a reference line. At O1 do the horizontal line. By using this protractor, take 45 degrees line. Here 45. Okay, so join this point to this point of axis. Just do one line here. Okay, on it mark this length, axis length, by using compass. Mark this length. Mark this point is apex. So this is the apex intersection point. Okay, this is the axis. Axis is two big lines with a dot. Like this. Now this is making axis is tilting 45 degrees with VP. Now after that, after marking O1, O here, mark the other points also. As we know, A and G are coming on the same line, on the axis line. Just extend this line for marking those points. Just extend it here. By using compass, take this length. O1G length and O1A length and O1G length same from O1 point. So mark this point is A point. This point is G point. Take the intersection points. These intersection points A and G. A and here it is G coming. Okay, think A and G. Okay, these two are centers. We can mark all other points. Follow the same process as in stage 3 first A bit for marking the points. Okay, so here I will take this distance, AL distance. Here I will do one arc. Similarly, I will take GL distance. Okay, I will cut from G as center. I will cut that arc. We will get one intersection point. Like that, we are getting all other points also, like A and G as centers. Follow the same process here, whatever we are doing. I am not keeping in the video. Follow the same procedure as we did in this case for marking these points. So here I got all the points. I joined whatever continuous lines are there we did the same continuous lines and dotted part I kept as it is. Same diagram we did here. The procedure is follow the procedure for marking the points. Okay, after getting this top view, final top view, do the projector lines at all the points. Take this is the reference line. Okay. After getting the projector lines, from these also do the projector lines. Take this is the reference. Here take the intersection points. A horizontal line, A vertical line, take intersection point A dash. B vertical line, B horizontal line. Take this is B dash. C horizontal, C vertical, take this is C dash. D horizontal line, D vertical line, take this is D dash. E vertical line, E horizontal line, take this is E dash. F vertical line, F horizontal line, take this is F dash. G vertical line, G horizontal line, okay, take this is G dash. H vertical line, H horizontal line, take this is H dash. I vertical line, I horizontal line, take I dash, and then J horizontal line, J vertical line, take this is J dash. K horizontal line, K vertical line, take this is K dash. L vertical line, L horizontal line, take this is A dash. Similarly mark center also, O1 vertical line, O1 horizontal line, okay, take this is O1 dash. And O vertical line, O1 dash horizontal line, take this is. After getting intersection points, join all outer points with continuous lines. What are the outer points? O1 dash, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, F dash, G dash, H dash, okay, and then I dash, curve will come here, and then O1 dash. What are the inner points? Means L dash, K dash, J dash, okay, these are the inner points. So outer points with continuous curves and here continuous lines. Okay, do with freehand curve. The remaining part should be with dotted lines. This is the final front view, final top view when the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to the vertical plane, and this is the stage 3 B bit. Okay, these are the all stages. In stage 1 we are assuming all points on the HP only. In next stage, at one of the point on the ground, axis is tilting 30 degrees with HP, and next this G point is on the ground only. If you observe all these diagrams, okay, here also G is on the HP only, and at this point only it is tilting. Main axis is tilting 45 degrees with the VP, and here this top view axis is tilting 45 degrees with VP. According to the first stage, first condition, resting on a point of the base circle on the ground. So this point, resting point is G point. In all these cases, G is on the HP only. And here mark the given dimension. Okay, take any one of the diameter, mark diameter 40, and take the axis height is 60. And in all the stages, both front view and top view should be in dark color. In the drawing sheet, you do with pencil. Don't use pens or sketch pens. Just for getting the clear views, I'm using different colors. If you like this lecture, please subscribe my channel and share with your friends. And other video lectures of projections of solids, I will give video link in description box. Please check it. Thank you for watching.